release is called The Painter's Garden, and you'll see why, and I'll explain it because of the colorful flowers I've chosen. This one is a tropical, although not everywhere grows these. I actually first saw them in Hawaii when my daughter got married on Maui, and they were just blooming everywhere. They're just gorgeous. So not too many pieces, and they're really easy to put together. So you have your main parts here, which will be your stem and what's called, it's the leaf sheath. Sometimes it's called the bract or the spathe. You know, it's the pod that holds the sepals and the petal. And then you've got these beautiful orange sepals that are blooming out. There's one little thing I'm going to explain on the, you know, I always give you how many to cut. This is 2 to 3. This says 2 times. A little mistake on the sepals. It says 3 times, and that's fine, but that's for 2 flowers. Normally these petals are 6-petal flowers, and you'll see what I'm going to do when we cut the, well, this one cut out. We'll actually create that group of them. So I cut out 3, but I've used 2 on 1, and I'm going to use 1 on this one. So let's get started. We'll push the petals aside so you can see what we're going to do. I'm going to start by coloring the stem. Now it's the interesting part of this is to keep your coloring pretty, you know, detailed. These have beautiful colors, and I'm going to start with, you know, this green. It's this is Olo. If you're using the Olos, it's YG85. And I'm adding just a little bit of that dark shading. I'm actually going to do that on both sides, and then I'm just lightly shading with a little bit darker color. And then I'm going to grab a lighter one, which is the YG8.3. and go over it, and really I'm going to blend this in. Now I'm not going to get too dark into this area that holds the bract or the spathe, however you want to call it, but I am going to blend. Oh, I'll blend on the back side too. I turn it over. There we go. Now, I like that it, you know, shades out there. These have, and I'm going to bring in the one I've done on the card just to show you. Look how you get that reddish tinge. Now, you can do 2 things, or whichever you want. If you have, you can use a little bit of distressed ink and shade some red around the edge, or you can also, you know, I like the pan pastels, and I'm going to shade, you know, into that a little bit. Also a little bit of the yellow. Now the other interesting thing is these stems are segmented, and so to get that look, just take a little darker red. And again, I'll show you on the sample here. You see that little division line, that segment. If you just kind of take a darker and go up a little bit, and I'm just lightly giving it that division, the way it goes together. Now, likewise, we're going to color this Beth. Now, I'm doing, I wanted the darker green, sorry. This is the YG8.5 again. I'm going to go darker here, but I've given you a little cut line here. That's where you can tuck your sepals and your petal together. So, but that also, that top part is actually, in my mind, a group of tepals, which is those orange petals. So I'm giving it a little bit of darkness here, and I'll again, you know, color some on the other side. Then I'm going to blend. But I'm leaving that top part. White right now, because I'm going to add some coloring with the orange, so you can, as if that's a group that hasn't burst open yet. So this is that lighter color you're going to get into. And this also gets some red tinge to it. So again, you can use a little bit of distressed ink. And I'm just going to shade underneath here. And maybe out to the tip and down here. And then I'm going to take my orange, this is 02.4, and do this top part. That's going to replicate a group of sepals. That's, you know, this group here, like this, as if they haven't burst open yet. And I'm going to darken it with a little bit of, this is R0.4. Oh, and I guess we should do it on the other side here. Forgot all about that. Not that you see it. It lays pretty flat down. It's really the orange petals that you're going to see. Okay. So we've got that part all set. I actually build right on my project. So I have a card, you know, very tropical looking, but you'll see these grow in groups of 2 to 3. So to replicate that, I always want to put at least 2. That's why if that one die for the petal says cut 3, yes, I cut 2 to go up here, and I did 1 more here. I'm going to do a little shaping first. So let me grab my loop tool. And on this stem, turn it over, right side down, and just go ahead and shape it. I'm going to do the same thing with this piece, right side down. And I'm really concentrating on that bottom part that I did in green. So I'm going over it a couple times. Remember, when you're putting your tips in, you pull down the collar and you're going to match where that little notch is and lock it into place. And you want it to go all the way down. The other thing is, it's better to go over several times. You'll see me just rubbing it rather than pressing real hard the first time. I'm softening that paper and getting it to come out. I'm going to just pinch this around a bit, and I'm going to add some pinching on the end here because it kind of comes to a point, and you can round this piece if you like. Make it look a little bit more dimensional. And then this is your stem. I'm curving those around. I softened this part because it holds. So what I'm going to do is glue that right into that. And that becomes, you know, your whole flower. So it's in 2 parts here. I'm going to go ahead and paint a little bit of glue on this stem. I'm using my glue pot here. And because this blooms in bunches, I already put the leaves down for a little bit to have behind. And then I'm going to set this in place. Just go ahead and put a little bit of glue on that part. And a little bit down this way. Now it's ready for the petals. So you've got the 2 sets. You've got the orange, which are called sepals, and then you've got that bluish kind of spiky looking thing. And it's actually called a petal. And I'm going to put two together. That's why when it says cut two, I put two in the flower like I have here. And I'll show you how I did that. But first, let's do the sepal. So it's in a set of three. And I am leaving a little bit of white at the end. That's why I cut these out of my specialty cardstock. I'll flip it over and do this side here. This color is 024 if you have the Olos. And then I want to darken it a bit, so I'm using that R0.4. I'm going to go over and just shade a little bit. I like that lighter. I'm not really trying to blend as much as just highlighting. So I'm at the base here a little bit darker, and as it gets into the tip there. But again, I'm leaving a little bit of white on it. Now this goes on your molding mat. And again, you're going to use your loop tool. Go ahead and first right sides down and just pull down from the outside going towards the center. Try not to do it the other way. You might pull these. These become very narrow at the ends. So it would be, you might pull them off. Now after you've shaped it a bit, you're going to use your tweezers. And you're going to go in and pinch these together. And then down each one of these sepals, you're going to pinch going down. This is right side up. And when you get to the tip, hold on to it and really pinch so you get that point. There you go. And then one more time here. And you can set them in. There's some going, since I did this one in orange, I'm going to set this one back this way so it'll kind of stand up. And so we'll add a little bit of glue to that. So I'm going to grab my pen again. And it looks like I want to hit this tip a little bit and hold that down. I've got some curve there, but I want to make sure that stays down. You've got the slit where I've created that cut line for you. So I'm going to just put some glue on this. And you can have them either heading backwards or towards the front. You know, there's some that go to the front there too. I had one tucked down, but I'm going to do this one in the front. Since this is the taller one and it would have gotten more sun, it's already bursted open. Okay, so I'm going to color two of these. And I've got a light blue and a very dark blue. I'm first going to add that dark blue. And right in there where the little notch is, go ahead and go around it with the blue and let it kind of, I try to get it to bleed a little bit. And it's very good with these Olos because they're really a lot wetter than the other pens. I set that aside. If you want, you can also go up the edge a little bit with that dark, because you're going to blend that in. And then with the lighter blue, go over it. Leaving the tip white. Is that? And I've colored both sides here. Now I'm going to put them on my mat. Let me pick them up here. They're actually going to go right on top of each other, but I want to put a little bit of glue here first. So you are going to put a little bit of glue down here by the tip and down here at the base. And then this one glues right on top of it. And then I'm going to grab my other tweezers. You're going to take I'm going to show you very carefully where you've got the two. See if I can get the split. It's there. Get your tweezer in there and roll it out. You're almost creating, it almost looks like an arrow. And then here too, roll that little bit out. So see, you've glued at the tip and the end, and then at the tip here, you also want to get that nice sharp point. So I'm pinching it around the tip of my tweezer so I get a nice sharp point. We're going to take and add a little bit of glue here. Oh, that's a lot of glue. And I'm going to slide one in the front here. And I've got this other one done, and it's all done the same way. I rolled it down, a little bit of glue on here. And I'm going to slide this one just towards the back here. There we go. Maybe just up a little bit. So now it's recognizable. That's the coloration. If you wanted to, you could have added, you know, another set of the sepals, and it could have gone in the front here. But I felt like this one hadn't quite bloomed yet. So let's do leaves next. So as you can see, we've got the two, the plate with two leaves on it, one a little bit smaller than the other, and it says cut 2 to 3. So I've cut 5 maybe. So I first have a darker green. These are a very green leaf. And very recognizable, because it also, if you look at mine here, has that red edge on it. So I'm doing that dark green first. That's YG87. And then this is actually a Copic color, YG67. To blend out and do some lightness at the end. And then I'm just going to color the back here real quick. But like I said, these have a lot of detail to them also. So if you bring in your leaf pad, and I'm going to grab my leaf tool here, I'm going to first do that line. This is that stem line, and I did it with the right side down, and I bend up on it. I'm going to grab my red here, my red pan pastel. You could have also used, but this has, it's a little windy today. You can hear my wind chimes out the window. Here in North Carolina, we've had a tropical storm go through. You also want to give a red line lightly down the center to accent that stem line. And then I'm going to switch over my pad here and add a little bit of yellow to the edges, because you've got that yellowish red. Kind of accentuates the flower. And now you want to put some, they have quite a bit of vein lines, so you're going to put them close together. And I'm not crossing over that stem line, but just drawing those veins coming out from the center of the leaf. And as you can see, the way I shape these, you just merely pinch them, and they're going to curve up kind of like a boat. And if you like, you can roll down some of the edges here to make them look a little natural. And let's put some leaves on our project to finish it off. They have quite a few leaves, so I'm going to really get these clumped together here. And then you have a beautiful plant. And plants are really full like this. So I would recommend, you know, when you're doing this one, to do at least two. You can certainly do more than that and put three or four in a clump, but they do grow like that. So as always, the last little bit to make this a complete project is to add my ladybug. I'm going to grab some glue here. I think I'll put her right up here. Very beneficial. They'll keep the aphids off your plants. And then a little bit of glaze on her. Now, for all you ladies who have live in a tropical area and grow these, you're very lucky. They wouldn't last the winter here, even in North Carolina. We can have them out in the summer, but we would have to cut them back and probably mulch over them. But they are beautiful and will bring back memories like they did for me going to Maui and having my daughter's wedding. So try the bird of paradise. It really does look like an exotic bird and quite colorful for the painter's garden.